thanks to you guys, man.
No, I need, but I need you to tell them. I need you to tell them about the foundation.
Yes, please.
You gotta do, please.
Yes. Oh, well, you know, we're a nonprofit 501c organization founded in 2005. And grandfather, boxing legend Henry Armstrong, to help those who are less fortunate. A lot of people don't realize before Henry Armstrong became famous, he was homeless, man. He came here in Los Angeles in the winter of 1930. He hoboed his way here with his trainer, Harry Armstrong. And when he arrived here, he had no money, no food, anything like that. So he went to the Midnight Mission. That particular mission fed him, helped him, and helped him got to the top, man. And so to this very day, we adopted the Midnight Mission. They're homeless men and women who are on the street, who are suffering day by day. And our organization, we're just a little light doing what we can to make a difference in their lives, to give them that opportunity, man, so they can, you know, become successful in their lives and help their families and their communities. And so we donate clothes, we give food out, volunteer our time and to make a difference. Being that COVID came around, it made things difficult for us in terms of really being able to get hands-on to help them, but we still deliver clothes. Matter of fact, we're going to be taking some more clothes down. We ask people to volunteer, if they could give clothes, socks, shoes, whatever they can do that's in good condition, and to be able to help us give those out to those people who are in need, man, that are suffering right now. And so in honor of Henry Armstrong, we're doing that. He also wanted to become a doctor, but he didn't have the funds. So that's the reason why he decided to box. So we have a scholarship program, athletic and a medical scholarship for young kids, for them to be able to get their scholarship and go to college and become a doctor, right, and enter the field of sports. Henry Armstrong graduated with honors. He was denied his scholarship based on his color. And so, it's heartbreaking to us that he was not able to go to school. So we're continuing that legacy to make sure that the kids in this future generation will not have to be discouraged that way. And we also have a positive youth program, psychology youth program, to teach young kids to be self-aware of their thoughts, man. As a man thinking in his heart, so is he. We tell these young kids to write the vision down and make it plain. This way they can see the end and the beginning. Henry Armstrong did the same thing. He visualized himself becoming a champion. You have to believe in yourself and put God first. God was with Henry Armstrong all the way, man. He was born 12-12-12. The 333s follow me everywhere I go. It's in our foundation paperwork. The 333 is on my office foundation door. When I open the door, my number has 333 in it. I pick up my phone, 333. I drive down the street, 333 is everywhere, man. It's the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. And so we've been doing this, staying faithful for 15 years. I'm a real estate broker in Los Angeles. For my commissions, I give back to the foundation. As president of this organization, I take no salary, man. I give back, and make a difference. Because I believe that these young kids have greatness inside of them. And my grandfather wanted these young kids to see his life,
That's right.
Definitely what I would like to do is I'd like to put up, put up your information, contact info or the movement or the foundation's information website up on our, in the description of the video so that, people can reach out if they need to. Definitely. I would definitely like to do that.
That would be an honor. We need everybody, man. We're asking people to come together as one, to make a difference, to improve the lives of others who are underserved, who are suffering, who are going through, hard times, man. And I think if these young kids raise their consciousness, there's nothing they can do. We tell them, follow your mind, and your behind will follow your mind, And so it's just that simple, that these young kids got to realize, man, that they have greatness inside of them, and there's nothing that they can't do, with God's help. And so we're encouraging them, inspiring them. We have one young student right now that's with us, Kevante. He lived in Texas, but he moved to Atlanta. And this young man he's a little fighter too. And he's a perfect role model for us, man. He completed his vision board. We rewarded this young man with $50. He's part of the positive program. He's thinking positive thoughts every day. He's being an example of the world. And so we want young kids to be able to do this And when I saw video of Floyd Jr., man, oh my God, you know, and his father who introduced him to him. I mean, I can't wait to shake your hand, man.
Honestly, they're honestly a pair, man. They're a pair. They get along well. I've been following him on social media for a long time now. You know, he's so humble. Junior, you're humble. You're a humble kid, man. You know, and dad, honestly, you're a role model for any father out there, man, that needs to, you know, get their ass in gear and,